I'm excited. So I want to say some words about pride, just to help us sink into this time, to sink into our bodies and the spirit moving in this place together. You know, this might surprise some of you, but pride is actually not typically a part of the liturgical Christian calendar. That's a big shock. And yet, I think that there is so much about the body of Christ and about the kingdom of God that pride can reveal to us. Yesterday was the 26th annual San Francisco Dyke March. Yeah. And so I want to invite us. They wrote this call to action for the gathering. And I want to invite us to experience this as the essence of pride and of queer liberation, and to ask ourselves, what does this mean for our worship here together? What does this mean for us as a Christian community and for our lives? Calling all dykes, take up space. Dyke is not just a sexual orientation, it's a political identity. It stands for community. It stands for solidarity. It stands for radical fight. It stands for trans and black, brown, queer, bisexual, lesbian, disabled, chronically ill, fat, femme, butch, indigenous, gender, expansive love. It does not stand by erasure, by displacement, by appropriation, by hate. We're calling all dykes, each and every one of you, to take up your space and hold it close to you as we hold on for our lives, as we hold on to each other. To take up space in a world that wants to erase us, to hold on to each other and celebrate who we are. To rise up in solidarity with one another. This is what pride is about. So yes, it is about parades, but maybe not so much about corporate sponsorship and the capitalization of pride. Yes, it's about rainbow flags, but not in ways that erase the diversity of each of us and our communities. It is possible that in this call, there are some words. Perhaps I've used some words already that make some of us uncomfortable, that we might find offensive. Words that come with a history of violence and oppression. For some of us in this congregation, words like queer and dyke have been used to hurt us. And maybe some of us have used these words to hurt others. But today we also honor the ways in which these words have been reclaimed by queer communities as a life-saving, life-giving source of power. So I invite us into these words, into the discomfort and the complexity of our beings and what God is doing anew here. All too often, this queer power has been excluded from sacred words and spaces. Pride is meant to empower those voices that have for too long been silent. Today we lift up identities and stories that have been called unworthy, evil, forsaken, unholy, and we call them by a new name, a name that the Creator has been calling out since the beginning. My delight, beloved. Today we are invited to open our eyes, ears, and hearts to both the witness of resurrection that is in this dyke call to action, and in the God's kingdom come way of life that is being brought forth. In this prayer of curiosity and hope, let us lift our voices together in praise of God. You're invited to stand as you are willing and able for the call to worship. People of God, join the crowd. Don't let the parade pass you by. Usually in our worship services, this would be the time when we bring our prayers of confession before one another and before God, a time when we face up to the sins that we have committed and that we participate in daily. And while this is an important and life-giving practice, the reality is that for many folks, queer folks, we've been told over and over again by churches that our very lives and identities are sinful. Some of us, when we enter a church and we see in the bulletin confession of sins, there is a feeling of fear. By sins, do you mean being gay? Am I going to be asked to deny who I am? Can I safely participate in this service?
So today we participate in our own reclaiming of this tradition. Rather than bringing our sins before God, we are invited to bring our affirmations through expressions of belovedness. Through this prayer of affirmation, we are invited to give voice to the multiplicity of God's queer creation and experience God's multiplicity as a source of power that can shape and reshape ourselves and our communities for the transformation and salvation of the world. Let us give thanks and pray. For women who nurture and care for living things, and men who bring love to birth, for people who create and people who procreate, we thank you.
We praise you for the love made flesh.
For men who lead with conviction and power, and women who wear the pants, for trans people who forge new pathways, and queers who break new ground, we thank you.
We praise you for the love made flesh.
For butches who protect the vulnerable, and femmes who defend the helpless, for communities who look out for the least of these, we thank you. For allies who offer extravagant hospitality and co-conspirators who welcome in the stranger, for chosen families who embrace others as kin, we thank you. For eunuchs who traverse boundaries and virgins who live outside the box, for widows who flout conventions and celibates who inhabit the in-between.
We praise you for the love made flesh.
For tomboys who challenge the status quo and sissies who imagine new possibilities, for ancestors who lived their way into a world transformed, we thank you.
We praise you for the love.
For all the ways we embody difference and discover commonality, for all the avenues we have to encounter your love, we thank you.
We're here. Let's praise God.
O God, whom no image can encompass, no definition encircle, and yet who meets us in the gentle and fierce touch of love, keep our hearts ever expanding so that we might rejoice in the extravagant abundance of your grace and revel in your infinite creativity. In the many names of the Holy One, we pray.
Amen.
From the earliest days of the Christian, the church communities have exchanged the sign of peace as a gesture of reconciliation, as an embodiment of the ways in which our love for God is manifest in our affirmation of the image of the divine present in each person. So today, you're invited to share a sign of peace through the singing of the song of a song and the sharing of a gesture. So first, let me teach you the song. It goes like this.
Whichever way you turn, whichever
shall sing aloud of your righteousness. The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love. The Lord is good to all, and his compassion is over all that he has made. All your works shall give thanks to you, O Lord, and your faithful shall bless you. They shall speak of the glory of your kingdom and tell of your power, to make known to all people your mighty deeds and the glorious pleasure of your kingdom. Your kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, and your dominion endures throughout all generations.
Holy wisdom, holy word. God's kingdom endures through all generations. Around the church, you might have noticed that there are images of queer ancestors and saints, people living and some who have died, who have inspired creativity and life and love. The icons that appear on this screen have all been created by queer artists. Their works both reclaim religious traditions that queer folks have been excluded from, and empower, uplift, and magnify the sacredness of those depicted. The many ways that each of these individuals speak of the glorious splendor of God. And at the back of the church and along the side wall and in the table in the back are other images and stories of dear ones. So for the next several minutes, I want to invite us to visit with these dear ones, to be in their presence and to catch a glimpse of their stories, to meditate on their good works. There are some rose petals in baskets. If you wish to scatter those on the pews in front of the images to offer up a prayer to the ancestors. And following in the Orthodox tradition, you're invited to reach out and to gently touch the saints, perhaps to even leave a kiss on the icons. How are these saints commending God's works to us? How are they blessing us and calling us forth? This time is for all of us to be in communion with the saints. And when you hear the powerful and wonderful voice of Mora bringing us back into song, I invite you to then begin to slowly return to your seats. Let us be in communion.
quiet for Zion's sake. I will not remain silent until Jerusalem's justice shines like the light of a new day, and her liberation blazes like a torch in the dead of the night. Jerusalem, the nations of the world will witness your righteousness. The most powerful world leaders will see your brilliance, and you'll be called something new, something brand new, a name given by none other than the Eternal One. And you will be the crowning glory of the Eternal's power. A royal crown cradles in God's palm and held aloft by your God for all to see. People won't talk about you anymore, using words like forsaken or empty. Instead, you will be called my delight, and the land around you, married. Because the Eternal is pleased with you and is bound to God's self to your land.
Holy wisdom, holy word.
Can you pray with me? God of our ancestors and our flesh and of our spirit, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of each and every one of our thoughts be a blessing in this place. May they spring forth from the source of your delight and guide us into your journey towards this precious and beautiful kingdom on earth, now and always. Amen. So often in our society, being LGBTQI, being queer, has been seen as a problem for the church, a problem for schools and public bathrooms, a problem for pronouns and grammar and language. We're told that being queer makes things harder, harder for ourselves, harder for everyone else. Because queerness disrupts binaries in a society set on believing that something is either this or this, and that there's no room for the in-between. Because we dare to tell the stories of our bodies, there are many ways of loving and changing and expressing themselves. In a society bent on repressing bodies, all bodies. Because for so long, for safety and spiritual nourishment and strength, we have had to rely on our communities and dance clubs rather than government and religious institutions. So for all of this and more, queerness is a disruption. And in this disruption, a blessing. My hope for today's service is that we open ourselves to the tremendous blessings of queer lives and communities. Blessings that have and will continue to create a world that is more compassionate and just and divinely creative. For me, LGBTQI pride, queer liberation, is an embracing of multiplicity. All of the ways that we talk, move, love, express, come together, struggle, resist, and create. It is bodies sweaty from dancing all day and night across borders that humans have created to falsely separate us from one another. It's a living out and into a kingdom vision of community that speaks of the realities of blood and suffering. A vision that says, come to the table so that we might know one another's struggles and all get free. I will not remain silent for Zion's sake until her liberation blazes like a torch in the dead of night. People won't talk about you anymore using words like forsaken and empty. Instead, you will be called my delight. This scripture sings out like a pride anthem. People won't talk about us anymore using words like sinner and pervert. Instead, we'll shout, we're queer, we're here, we're here, we're queer. Either way. And we are God's delight. I hear the chants of other movements rising up in this anthem as well. People won't talk about you anymore using words like illegal, alien, criminal, thug. Instead, every street will swell with the sounds of migration is beautiful, Black Lives Matter, and the liberation of all peoples will blaze like a torch. For me, pride is a verb. It is the ministries, the actions, and ways of being that emerge and come together at all of these intersections. When we're here and we're queer, is bound with Black Lives Matter, is bound with migration, is beautiful, and all will be called God's delight. As the prophet and saint Audre Lorde wrote, there is no such thing as a single issue struggle because we do not live single issue lives. The legacies and future of pride invite us today to refresh our journey, to perhaps look at the pilgrimage that we have been on as a Christian community and experience it from queer teachings of kingdom making. Teachings that emerge from these intersections and the in-between places. One of the reasons that I became a Christian minister is because of what being queer taught me. And because I couldn't understand how it seemed to me like a particularly queer faith was taken and then used against us. Now, some of you might ask, a queer faith? Huh. So let's revisit this Dyke March call to action, put it alongside the scripture passage, and explore what it might be to imagine a queer God and a queer faith. The first line reads, Dyke is not just a sexual orientation. Now, as a dyke, I feel that this is true. And as a minister preaching from a Christian pulpit, having lived with Christian repression and oppression, I also don't want to just completely jump right past the power of sexual identities. We as LGBTQI folks have long since been reduced entirely to what kind of sex we do and do not engage in. And while I find this gaze from the outside frustrating, harmful, and sometimes life-threatening, I believe that queer folks and communities have also turned it into a blessing. In a society that wants to both privatize and exploit sexuality, queer resistance and imagination has responded by offering the world glimpses of and resources for actually embracing our bodies and sexualities in all of their complexities and fluidities. We have helped offer tools for sex-positive conversations, safe words, and awareness of consent, and the opportunity for everyone to ask, explore, and remain open to gender and sexuality rather than assume or be prescribed. LGBTQI pride and queer liberation extends this blessing. Our bodies and sexualities are porous, in motion, expanding, divine. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. This God who we believe in, who became flesh and dwelt among us, who embraces the body so fully in its struggle and vulnerability and longing, I see this as a queer God, a God of multiplicity, a God who crosses the borders between us for the sake of love, a God who lives, dies, and rises for the liberation of all. You will be called my delight. The Eternal is pleased with you and has bound God's self to you until your liberation burns like a torch. Like the dyke call to action, this is a God and a faith legacy that stands for community, stands for solidarity, stands for radical fight, stands for trans, black, brown, queer, bisexual, lesbian, disabled, chronically ill, fat, femme, butch, indigenous, gender, expansive love. Now, the queer community hasn't always been so good at this. We haven't always recognized that our connections to folks who are different from us. We had to learn to reach out and create connections between gay men and lesbians during the AIDS crisis. We had to learn, and are still very much learning, to find solidarity with our trans and intersex kin, and remember that they were the ones who began our liberation journey at Stonewall. In the fight for marriage equality, we have had to not lose sight of our visions for expansive relationships and families. We have had to address our racism, ableism, colonialism, and so much more. We haven't always done it in life-giving ways, and there still is so much to do. But we are learning that to be queer means to be multiple, complex, and radically resistant, even as we hold on to one another. The queer community's struggle to expand its vision and reach toward one another is also a blessing through which we can see the divine working in and among us. In this struggle and journey, I experience again the queer God, this God who became flesh and dwelt among us, who reaches out across borders and limitations humans have placed on one another, this God who says, this can be so much different, beloveds. We can all reach out towards one another for our salvation, for the kingdom of God on earth. We can be and must be all of these expressions coming together. This gracious, tender, fierce, queer God made flesh looked around and said, you ask me, who are my mother, my brother, my sister, and I say to you, you are my mother, my brother, my sister. Like the blessing of chosen family and the expansiveness of queer community was always the vision that God had for the kingdom. So many queer folks have had to leave their families, leave their blood relatives behind in order to find flourishing. So many trans youth have been kicked out of their homes and have had to find family in the streets. And so queer folks have found ways to create families, to bring together the people who will be our people, our kin, and to discover that those who are already around us are, in fact, our mothers, our brothers, sisters, and siblings. And I invite us to think, what would the church look like if we had this vision too? What would the expansiveness of queer community and chosen family really mean for how we do worship and ritual, how we pray and teach? What would it ask of our offerings, our space, and our going forth? What would it require of us as we see children separated from their parents and held in warehouses and cages at the border? What would it require of us when we walk by homeless youth sleeping on our church lawn? Beloveds, I pray that as a more light church, a church that has proclaimed itself to be welcoming of LGBTQI folks, that we heed the Dyke Pride call as a Christian call to action. I pray that we learn from our queer ancestors who stayed in the struggle and whose torch we now carry. That we be a church whose understanding of community and solidarity continues to expand and open. I pray that we come to embrace gender fluidity and the creativity of gender pronouns, not as a problem, but as a blessing, a reflection of each of us dancing to the tune of God calling us, naming us, my delight. I pray that we will not keep silent for the sake of heaven, not until hate is replaced by expansive love, not until we are bound to one another, not until we deeply know one another as kin and displacement is replaced by beloved community. No, church, let us not keep quiet for the sake of heaven. Until the blessings of a queer God flow from this place, when liberation burns like a torch, and a new day comes. Amen.